Shabbat shalom to you who are here today, and Shabbat shalom to all of you who are watching us online. We are starting our Shabbat morning service on page 112 with Matovu. Eternal God, a mystery surrounds my life. What came before it and what lies beyond it are shrouded in darkness. But in the darkness is your presence, and in the mystery your love. No mind can grasp the splendor of your being, no tongue express the majesty of your works. Yet there are times when we sense a reality that is beyond our mortal sight. May this Sabbath be such a time for us. Help us to hear your voice, to find your image in our souls, and to be at peace. On page 113. My God, the soul you have given me is pure, for you have created it and formed it and breathed it into me, and you sustain it within me. So long as there is a soul within me, I will give thanks to you, Eternal One, my God, and God of my ancestors, Sovereign of all worlds, Guide of every human soul. We praise you, O God, in whose hands are the souls of all the living and the spirits of all flesh. Baruch she'amah ve'aya olam baruch hu. Baruch ata Adonai Eloheinu melech ha'olam ha'mehulal befiyamo meshubar umfoar bileshon chasidav ha'avadav בשבחות ובזמירות נגדל לך ונמלירך מלכנו יחיד העולמים ברוך אתה אדוני מלך מעולל בתשבחות. Page 114. To you the stars of morning sing, from you the radiance bright did spring. And steadfast in the vigils, day and night, your angels, flooded with favor, ring your praise. They teach the holy ones to bring into your house the breath of early light. Hashamayim mesabchim kevod el u'maase yadav magid harkiya. The heavens declare the glory of God. The sky proclaims God's handiwork. Day unto day utters speech. Night unto night teaches knowledge. Yet there is no speech, there are no words, not a sound of them is heard. And still, their call goes out to all the earth, and their message to the end of the world. God's teaching is perfect, reviving the soul. God's word is unfailing, making wise the simple. God's precepts are right, delighting the mind. God's commandments are clear, enlightening the eyes. God's doctrine is pure, enduring forever. God's guidance is true and altogether just. There are more to be desired than gold, than any amount of fine gold, sweeter than honey from the honeycomb. A servant pays heed to them, for on keeping them much depends. Who is aware of errors? Cleanse me, therefore, of unconscious sins. Hold back your servant also from willful sins. Let them not control me. Then I shall be blameless and innocent of grave transgressions. May the words of my mouth and the meditation of my heart be acceptable to you, O God, my rock and my redeemer. אני מזמירות ושירים אהרוג, כי אליך נפשי תהרוג. נפשי חימדה בצל ידיך, לדעת כל רע סודיך. מידי דברי בכבודיך, אומה ליבי אל דודיך. ירב נסיכי עליך, כי נפשי תהרוג אליך. Please stand. And we turn to page 135 for the Yishtabach, 135 for Yishtabach.
Yishtabach shimcha lad malkeinu, האל המלך הגדול והקדוש בשמיים ובארץ. כי לך נאי אדוני אלוהינו ואלוהי אבותינו ואמותינו, שירו שבחה הלל וזמחה ברכות והודעות מעתה ועד עולם. ברוך אתה אדוני הבוחר בשירי זמחה. ברכו את אדוני המבורך. ברוך אדוני המבורך לעולם ועד.
Please be seated. Page 136. You can sit. Yeah, with this one, 136. Yeah. Yeah, with the same, yeah, absolutely, yes. 36. 36, yes. We praise you, Eternal One, our God, Sovereign of the Universe, Maker of Light and Creator of Darkness, Author of Peace and Creator of all things. In your mercy, you give light to the earth and all who live on it. And in your goodness, you renew creation continually day by day. How manifold are your works, O God! With wisdom have you made them all. The world is full of your creations. Your handiwork proclaims your praise. The radiant stars bear witness to your glory. We praise you, O God, Creator of light. Great is your love for us, Eternal God, and abundant your compassion. Our ancestors trusted in you, and you taught them the laws of life. So be gracious to us and teach us. Incline our hearts to hear your words, to know and understand, to learn and teach, and with love to uphold the truth of your Torah. Enlighten us with your teaching. Make us faithful to your commandments, and wholehearted in the love and awe of your name. For in love you summon us to serve you and proclaim your unity. We praise you, O God. In love you have called Israel, your people, to serve you. Please stand.
Shema Yisrael, Adonai Eloheinu Adonai Echad Baruch Shem Kevod Malchuto Leolam Vaed
Ve'ahavta et Adonai Elohecha Bechol Levavecha Uvechol Nashecha Uvechol Meodecha Ve'hayu Hadvarim Ha'ele Asher Anochi Metzavera Hayom Al Levavecha ושיננתם לבניך ודיברת בם בשבתך בביתך ובלכתך בדרך ובשרבך ובקומך וקשרתם לאות על ידיך והיו לתותפות בין עיניך וכתבתם על מזוזות ביתך ובשעריך
למען תזכרו ועשיתם את כל מצוותיי ויהייתם קדושים לאלוהיכם אני אדוני אלוהיכם אשר הוצאתי אתכם מארץ מצרים להיות לכם לאלוהים אני אדוני אלוהיכם.
Good and beautiful and true, sound, established and enduring are these words now and forever. True it is, Eternal One, that you are Sovereign God and Redeemer, as you were the God of and Redeemer of ancestors. You are our Maker, the Rock of our salvation. We have known you always as our Helper and our Liberator. There is no God but you. Truly you are first and you are last. We have no Redeemer but you. You redeemed us from Egypt and freed us from the house of bondage. Then, with great joy, Moses, Miriam, and all Israel together sang to you this song.
Micha mocha ba'elim Adonai, Micha mocha nedar ba'kodesh nora, Tehilot Osefele Nora Tehilot Osefele
Shira Chadasha Shibru Gileuin Leshimcha Al Sfat Hayam Yachad Kulam Hodu Vimlichu Vyamaru
Adonai Imlor Leolam Vaed Sur Israel Kuma Bezrat Israel Goaleinu Adonai Tzevaot Shemo Kedosh Israel Baruch Atah Adonai Gal Israel Gal Israel Israel.
Please stand, and we're on page 140 for the Amidah.
Adonai sefatai tiftach ufi yagit tehilatecha. Eternal God, open my lips that my mouth may declare you praise.
Baruch atah Adonai, Eloheinu ve'Elohei avoteinu ve'imoteinu, Elohei Avraham, Elohei Yitzhak ve'Elohei Yaakov, Elohei Sarah, Elohei Rivka, Elohei Rachel ve'Elohei Lea, Ha'el Hagadol Hagibor ve'Anocha, El Elyon, Gomel Chasadim Tovim ve'Kone Hakol, ve'Zoreh Chasdei Avod ve'Imaot, ומביא גאולה לבני בניהם למען שמו באהבה. מלך עוזר ומושיע ומגן. ברוך אתה, אדוני, מגן אברהם ועזרת שרה. אתה גיבור לעולם, אדוני, מחיה מת עם אתה רב להושיע. משיב הרוח ומוריד הגשם, מזריח השמש ומוריד התן.
מחלקל חיים בחסד, מחיה מתים ברחמים רבים, סומך נופלים ורופא חולים, ומתיר אסורים, ומקיים אמונתו lishene afar michamo chabal gevurot umidomelach melech me mitu mechaye umatzmiya yeshua ונאמן אתה לחיות מתים, ברוך אתה אדוני מחיי המתים. We sanctify your name on earth, as in the prophet's vision the host of heavens sing your praise above, for so it is written.
Kadosh, 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 Adonai Tzevaot, Meloch Kol Haaretz Kevodo.
Kevodo male olam.
Baruch kevod Adonai mimekomo.
Mimkomcha malkeinu tofia, v'timloch aleinu ki mechakim anachnu lach.
Yimloch Adonai leolam, Elohayir Tzion, ledov ador, Alleluia. Ledov ador, ledov ador, ledov ador, nagid god lecha. Ledov ador, ledov ador, ledov ador, nagid god lecha. Ulenetzach netzachim, ulenetzach netzachim, kedushakta, nagdish. ולנצח נצחים, ולנצח נצחים, קדושתך נדיש. לדור ודור, לדור ודור, לדור ודור נגיד גוד לך. לדור ודור, לדור ודור, לדור ודור נגיד גוד לך. ושברכה אלוהינו מפינו לא ימוש, לא ימוש לעולם ועד. ושברכה אלוהינו מפינו לא ימוש, לא ימוש לעולם ועד.
ברוך אתה אדוני האל הקדוש. Please be seated. You inspired our ancestors to hallow this day for your service. When upon its coming we pause to contemplate our life, we learn anew that we do not live by bread alone, but also by the spiritual nourishment we receive when we open ourselves to your influence. We thank you for the Sabbath day and for the opportunity it offers to enhance the quality of our lives. We thank you for its joy and for its peace. May our worship help us to take into our hearts its message of holiness and consecrate all our days by devotion to what is true, beautiful, and good.
Yismechu b'malchutcha, yismechu b'malchutcha, shomrei shabbat v'korei oneg, amekatshe shevi'i, מקדשי שביעי כולם יסבאו והינתנגו מטובך והשביעי והשביעי רצית בו וקידשתו חמדת ימים חמדת ימים אותו קראת זכר למעשה וראשית.
Our God and God of ancestors, may our rest be pleasing on your sight. Sanctify us by your commandments and make us loyal to your teaching. Satisfy us with your goodness, gladden us with your salvation, and purify our hearts to serve you in truth. In your gracious love, Eternal One, let the holiness of your Sabbath enter our hearts, and may all Israel who hallow your name be exalted by its peace. We praise you, O God, for the holiness of the Sabbath. Eternal God, be gracious to people Israel, and in your love accept their prayers. May our worship now and always be acceptable in your sight. We praise you, O God, whom alone we worship in reverence. Modim anachnu lach. We give thanks that you, Eternal One, are our God, as you were the God of ancestors. You are the rock of our life, the power that shields us in every age. We thank and praise you for our lives which are in your hand, for our souls which are in your keeping, and for the signs of your presence we encounter every day, and for your wondrous gifts at all times, morning, noon, and night. We praise you, O God, source of goodness, to whom our thanks are due.
Sim shalom tova uvracha, chen v'chesed v'rachamim v'rachamim aleinu, ve'al kol Yisrael, ve'al kol Yisrael amecha, b'cheinu avinu kulanu ke'echad, be'opanecha. Ki ve'opanecha natata lanu, Adonai Eloheinu. Sim shalom tova uvracha, chen v'chesed v'rachamim v'rachamim aleinu. Aleinu ve'al kol Yisrael, ve'al kol Yisrael amecha, Torat chaim ve'ahavat chesed, utzdakah uvracha, ve'rachamim ve'chaim ve'shalom, ve'rachamim ve'chaim ve'shalom. Sim shalom tova uvracha, chen v'chesed ve'rachamim ve'rachamim aleinu ve'al kol Yisrael, ve'al kol Yisrael amecha, ve'tov ve'tov b'enecha, leva'echer et amcha Yisrael, ve'et kol ha'amim b'chol et uv'chol shah, b'shlomecha. Sim shalom tova uvracha, chen v'chesed v'rachamim v'rachamim aleinu ve'al kol Yisrael, ve'al kol Yisrael amecha.
Baruch atah Adonai Yosei HaShalom. We praise you, O God, the source of peace. And with God's peace on our heart, we take a few moments for private prayer and meditation.
So now it's the time for our Torah service, and I just wanted to say a few words before that. I've decided to not to start at the beginning of Parashat Pinchas, because Parashat Pinchas is actually starting in the middle of a story that starts at the end of Parashat Balak, last week's parasha. So I will read chapter 25 from the book of Numbers. The whole chapter, even though it starts in the previous parasha. And I also wanted to say something about something I did this morning. I went to the UPJ Pride Shabbat. It's the first time the UPJ and the European Rabbinic Assembly organized a Pride Shabbat. So it was, of course, continental time, which is an hour before us, which allowed me to have the pleasure to have two services this Shabbat. And we had an amazing Dvar Torah by Rabbi Elitik Vassara, who is the Emeritus Rabbi of Brighton and Hove. And I will use a bit what she said, because it was a very, very good Dvar Torah. And she didn't preach on this passage that I'm going to use later for our Torah service. She preached on the daughters of Tzelofchad, and she talked about her experience as being the first ever lesbian rabbi to be ordained at Leo Beck College in 1989, which was a big, big move for a progressive rabbinic school. Rabbi Elitik Vassara and Rabbi Sheila Shulman, Zichrona Livracha, were the first LGBTQI plus rabbi to be ordained in Britain. And today, rainbow rabbis, as she called them, amount to 20% of British rabbinate, and it's also coming up in Europe, showing the diversity of humankind. And she said a few things I just wanted to share before I'm going into the Torah portion. So I think we'll make this Dvar Torah available to you on the website. So she paid tribute to Rabbi Lionel Blue, whom we all know. Rabbi Lionel Blue was actually the first rabbi who came out in the 1980s, when it was still a criminal offense to be gay. And he came out in 1981, and he was, he's a national treasure to this day. He wrote many books, and he was such a sweet person. And he was also the mentor of Rabbi Elitik Vassara when she was a student rabbi. Rabbi Sheila Shulman was actually my mentor when I was a student rabbi. She ordained me just a few months before she passed away, so she was very important to me as well. So she also mentioned the fact that today there are many progresses have been made allowing LGBTQI plus people to just enjoy their human rights. But she also mentioned the fact that 71 countries continue to criminalize LGBTQI plus people, including 32 African nations, 23 nations of Middle East and Asia, 9 nations in the Americas, and 7 nations in Oceania. So it's not all good news, of course. And also the law that was passed in 2013 in Russia, enacting an anti-gay propaganda law. So there's much work to do still for LGBTQI plus people, and for all minorities, really, and because it's just an aspect of the problem of a society that, I'm not talking about Britain, which is a very open society in that respect, but worldwide, where minorities are not always heard. So I will say what she's her conclusion, because she talked a bit about Pinchas, the character I will mention in my own Dvar Torah, but I will tell you this later. So if you have a Chumash, it's Numbers 25, verses 1 to 18. And I just wanted to say hello to our friends who have joined us today. So I can see that Rebecca who is waiting for her students' concert today. So she's not here playing the piano, but good luck with your students today. And Meira, who is watching us from Sydney in Australia. Gosh, what time is it now in Sydney? Yeah, it's 8 o'clock, I think. And okay, we also have Carol Goldring, who is here today with us. Vince, Dominique, Deborah, Sarah, Sibyl, Tina, and Neil, James, Russell, and Michelle. So Shabbat Shalom to you all, and of course to all of you who are watching us on different channels, and I can't see their names, so it's It's a warm welcome to you all. So we are on page 481.
En kamocha va'elohim Adonai ven kemasecha malchutecha malchut kol olamim u'memshaltecha bechol dor va'dor. Please stand. Adonai melech, Adonai malach, Adonai imloch le'olam va'ed. Adonai od yamo yiten, Adonai evachet et amo v'shalom.
Shema Yisrael, Adonai Eloheinu, Adonai Echad.
Echad Eloheinu, Gadol Adonainu, Kadosh Shemo.
Gadolu Adonai Yiti, Unerumama Shemo Yachtav.
Lecha Adonai Yagedula, Ve'agevura, ve'atiferet, ve'anetzar, ve'ahavot, kichol ba'shamayim v'aret. Lecha Adonai ha'mamlacha, ve'amitnase lechol erosh. Oromemu Adonai Eloheinu, ve'ishtachavu le'har kodesho, ki kadosh Adonai Eloheinu.
Please be seated. So, in, you know, there are two main genres in biblical literature and rabbinic literature as well. You have halacha, which is law, and agada, which is story or narrative. And here we have a perfect example of agada, of a story that became the object of scrutiny by the rabbis in the Talmud, and I will talk about this later, how the narrative of a society is transformed into a law, you know, how what we live becomes actually the law. Because the law can be forward-looking, can come, you know, to push a society ahead, but also an emanation of the problem of the current issues that the society is facing. So this is what happens in this story at the end of Balak. When Israel was staying at Shittim, the people profaned themselves by whoring with the Moabite women, who invited the people to the sacrifices for their god. The people partook of them and worshipped that god. Thus Israel attached itself to Baal Peor, and the Eternal was incensed with Israel. The Eternal said to Moses, "Take all the ringleaders and have them publicly impaled before the Eternal, so that the law, the Eternal's wrath may turn away from Israel." So Moses said to Israel's officials, "Each of you slay those of his men who attach themselves to Baal Peor." Just then one of the Israelites came and brought a Midianite woman over to his companions in the sight of Moses and all the whole Israelite community, who were weeping at the entrance of the tent of meeting. When Pinchas, son of Eleazar, son of Aaron the priest, saw this, he left the assembly, and taking a spear in his hand, he followed the Israelite into the chamber and stabbed both of them, the Israelite and the woman, through the belly. Then the plague against the Israelites was checked. Those who died of the plague numbered 24,000. The Eternal spoke to Moses, saying, "Pinchas, son of Eleazar, son of Aaron the priest, has turned back my wrath from Israelites by displaying among them his passion for me,
so that I did not wipe out the Israelites' people in my passion. Say therefore, I grant him my pact of friendship. It shall be for him and his descendants after him a pact of priesthood for all time, because he took impassioned action for his God, thus making expiation for Israelites. The name of the Israelite who was killed, the one who was killed with a Midianite woman, was Zimri, the son of Salu, chieftain of Simeonite ancestral house. The name of the Midianite woman who was killed was Cosby, daughter of Tzur. He was a tribal head of an ancestral house in Midian. The Eternal spoke to Moses, saying, "Assail the Midianites and defeat them, for they assail you by the trickery they practiced against you, because of the affair of Peor, and because of the affair of the kinswoman Cosby, daughter of the Midianite chieftain, who was killed at the time of the plague on account of Peor." So there's a lot of violence, there's a lot of zealotry, so we'll talk about this a bit later, but let's hear what the scroll says to us today. So we'll invite you to join me to say the blessings together as a community today, okay? Oh, you can stay. You can stay where. Yeah. You can stay where you sit. Okay. Let's say together. Baruch Hu Et Adonai Hamevorach. Baruch Adonai Hamevorach Leolam Vaed. Baruch Ata Adonai Eloheinu Melech Haolam. Asher bachar banu mikol ha'amim, v'natan lanu et Torato. Baruch ata Adonai, noten ha'Torah. Amen. Vayeshev Yisrael bashitim, ויחל העם לזנות אל בנות מואב. ותקרנה להם לזבחי אלוהיהן. ויאכל העם וישתחוו לאלוהיהן. ויצמד ישראל ועל פרור. ויחך אף אדוני בישראל. ויאמר אדוני אל משה, קח את כל ראשי העם, והוקע אותם לאדוני נגד השמש, וישוב חכון אף אדוני מישראל. ויאמר משה אל שופטי ישראל, הרגוהו הישן השב, הנצמדים לבעל פאור. והנה איש מבני ישראל בא, ויקרב אל אחיו את המדיינית לעיני משה ולעיני כל הדעת בני ישראל, והם הבוכים פתח אוהל מועד. וירא פנחס בן אלעזר בן אהרן הכהן, ויקום מתוך העדה, ויקר אומר בידו, ויבוא אחר ישראל אל הקובה, וידקור את שניהם, את איש ישראל ואת האישה אל הקובתה. ותיעצר המגפה מעל בני ישראל. ויהיו המתים במגפה,
ארבעים ועשרים אלף. וידבר אדוני אל משה לאמור, פנחס בן אלעזר, בן אהרן הכהן, השיב את חמתי מעל בני ישראל, בקנהו את קנהתי בתוכם, ולא חיליתי את בני ישראל. בקנהתי לכן אמור, הנני נותן לו את בריתי שלום, והייתה לו ולזכו אחריו ברית כהונת עולם תחת אשר קינה לאלוהיו ויכפר על בני ישראל ושם איש ישראל המוכה אשר וכה את המדיינית זמרי בן סלו נשיא ותב לשימונים ושם האישה המוכה המדיינית קוזבי וצור ראש ומוד בבית האב במדיין הוא וידבר אדוני אל משה לאמור צרור את המדיינית וכיתם אותם כי צורחים הם לכם ונכלה נכלהם אשר נקלו לכם על דבר פהור ועל דבר קוזבי קוזבי ואת נשיא מדיין אחותם המוקם ביום המגפה על דבר פהור.
Okay, we said together the next blessing.
ברוך אתה אדוני אלוהינו מלך העולם אשר בחר בנו מכל העמים ותתן לנו את תורתו ברוך אתה אדוני נותן התורה אמן.
I think I just repeated the first. Okay.
ברוך אתה אדוני אלוהינו מלך העולם אשר נתן לנו תורת אמת וחיי עולם נתן בתוכנו ברוך אתה אדוני נותן התורה אמן.
Please stand.
ברוך שנתן תורתו, ברוך שנתן תורתו לעמו ישראל בקדושתו.
So please be seated. I'm going to dress the scroll. So you remember that for because we're doing mainly Zoom services at the moment, we still don't have a haftarah, so not to exhaust our members who are watching us online. And if you bear with me just a moment, it should be very quickly done. We can't touch together the scroll still. It's always these weird rules, huh? Okay, please stand. We are now on page 484. Eternal God, whose dominion embraces the universe, we ask your blessing for our Sovereign Lady, Queen Elizabeth, and all the royal family, for those who govern our country, and all who influence the quality of its national life. Make them conscious of their responsibility and teach them to exercise it in accordance with your will. May we all help to fashion in this country a society that excels in freedom and justice, tolerance and compassion, so that it may be a force for righteousness and peace in the life of humanity. Eternal God, as you blessed our ancestors in generations past, bless now this congregation, its leaders and its members, and all who enter this synagogue to meet, to study, and to pray. Comfort the sorrowing hearts among us and heal those in anxiety or pain. May we all find here community and friendship, renewal and purpose and hope, a deeper understanding of our heritage, and a sense of your abiding presence. Bless all the congregations of the House of Israel throughout the world. Let those who live under oppressive rule soon be freed, and may we all unite to witness to your truth and do your will. Eternal God, our Rock and Redeemer, grant blessing to the State of Israel, created to fulfill an age-old dream, and to be a haven for the oppressed. Inspire its leaders and citizens with faithfulness to the aims of its founders, to develop the land for the benefit of all its inhabitants, and to implement the prophetic ideals of liberty and justice. May they live in harmony with one another and in peace with their neighbors, and cause to come true once more the ancient vision that out of Zion shall go forth Torah and the word of God from Jerusalem. Turn to page 486.
Odu ale retz veshamayim vayarem kerele amo tehila lechol chasidav livne Yisrael am kerovo. Alleluia, Alleluia.
On page 489.
Ki lekar tov natati lachem Torati, al tazovu etz chayim hi lamachazikim ba. ותומכיה מאושר, דרכיה דרכי נועם, וכל נתיבותיה שלום. השיבנו אדוני אליך, ונשובה.
Each nation creates its own narrative, a narrative that defines its core values, its points of reference, a language that is understood by all and offers a sense of common destiny and belonging. History, or at least official history, is at the heart of what we can call national narrative. In the 1990s, the French historian Benjamin Stora coined the expression lieu de mémoire, which can be translated as places of remembrance. You know, those events in the national narrative that bring a nation together. In Britain, for example, the successful retreat in Dunkirk in 1940, the Spanish Armada defeated by Elizabeth I's navy in 1588, or even the Battle of Bosworth Field in 1485 that marked the advent of the Tudor dynasty plays such a role. In France, in a fortnight, we will celebrate the 14th of July, which is also called the Bastille Day. We remember the storming of the Bastille and the beginning of a revolutionary period on this day of July in 1789. When the Parisian insurgents took the Bastille, they found only 6 prisoners, which did not really add up to the accepted idea that this prison was the symbol of absolutism in France. However, one could be imprisoned with a simple lettre de cachet, which is a letter signed by the king and closed with a royal seal. It was an exceptional procedure that was completely outside any court of law, and it became the epitome of royal absolutism. The tall medieval castle cast its shadow over Paris, and its capturing was perceived as a sign of freedom by the population. This event was commemorating the following year, in 1790, as Fête de la Fédération, the Festival of the Federation, celebrating the end of the absolute monarchy. Of course, at that moment, nobody would have imagined what was coming up in the next few years: the abolition of the monarchy in 1792, the king put on trial and beheaded, the advent of the empire with Napoleon Bonaparte, the fall of Napoleon, the restoration, other revolutions. So in total, over 2 centuries, we had 2 empires, 3 monarchies, and 5 republics. Revolution in France was the story of a people which took its fate into its hands, but was also betrayed by its elites, and would have certainly never imagined all the blood and the violence that came with it. The French national anthem, the Marseillaise, reflects those troubled times. I don't know if you ever read a translation, but it talks about blood, violence, enemies who come into our country to take our wives and partners, and the final victory of the people. Before being a rabbi, I was a history teacher, and it was my duty to teach my students La Marseillaise, and I always felt very uncomfortable with its words. Of course, every revolution comes with blood and violence, and you know this very well, as Britain had beheaded its king more than a century before France. However, nobody in France would have dreamed of amending the text or change anthem. It would be considered as anti-national. So my way to teach this text was to put violence into context. I would explain to my students that this period was like a birth. It was painful, very painful, and sometimes very difficult, but the result was a new life and all its potentials. Violence in context is what we need to understand for our weekly Torah portion. We learned at the very end of last week's portion that Pinchas turned away God's wrath against Israel when the people engaged in a mass orgy involving Moabite women and Moabite gods. Moses got a direct order from God to take all the ringleaders and have them publicly impaled before the Eternal. And in response, Moses ordered Israelite officials to, and I quote, slay those who attach themselves to the idol Baal Peor. Later on, an Israelite man blatantly consorted with a Midianite woman within sight of Moses and Aaron and the whole congregation. And then Pinchas was Aaron's grandson, followed the two into the chamber and stabbed both of them through the belly. God's plague against the Israelites was checked, but not before 24,000 people died. Now, at the start of this week's parasha, Pinchas is rewarded by God for his passion for me, so that I did not wipe out the Israelites' people in my passion. God grants Pinchas a Brit Shalom,
which was translated in various ways as covenant of peace, a pact of friendship, or in the Hasidic world, they have a nice translation, a covenant of wholeness and fulfillment. Shlemut, shalom shlemut is the same root. That covenant shall be for Pinchas and his descendants a berit kehunat olam, a pact of priesthood for all times. Pinchas' passion or zealotry is explicitly related to God's in verse 10. Bekan'o et kin'ati, his passion or zeal, for my passion or zeal. The Torah seems to be saying that one can imitate God not only through acts of justice and mercy, creation and redemption, but also in hot anger, violence and slaughter. This is not the Judaism we cherish, but there it is, or seems to be, written in black and white in our Torah scroll. Of all the challenges Torah places before a reader determined to walk in its path, to follow its guidance, and to try to ascertain that, in the words of the book of Proverbs, all its ways are pleasantness and all its paths are peace, these incidents at the heart of the book of Numbers appear to be among the very hardest of all of them. My Talmud teacher at Leoberg College, Dr. Lalif Kleinman, used this passage to teach that Talmud is actually Torah in context, that we do not necessarily need to agree with every single word of Torah, and that our rabbis found ways to make it more acceptable. So there is a passage in the Talmud tractate Sanhedrin, which is a tractate that discusses laws and civil courts and criminal courts. So this is what the Talmud says. Rabbi Chisda said, if the zealot comes to the Beit Din to take counsel whether to punish a transgressor, we do not instruct him to do so. In other words, you can't do justice yourself. What is more, had Zimri, you know, the guy who was killed by Pinchas, had Zimri forsaken his mistress and Pinchas slain him, Pinchas would have been executed on his account. And had Zimri turned upon Pinchas and slain him, he would not have been executed, since Pinchas was a pursuer seeking to take his life. In other words, Pinchas would have been accused of murder and suffered capital punishment, and Zimri would have been exonerated for defending his life. The rabbis here knew that the law is not helped when people take it into their hands. God would not, in their view, have rewarded lawless behavior. Violence can quickly spiral out of control. And that's one of the important lessons in the Talmud is we have this text, we have a Torah text, which is given to us by Moses according to our tradition, and yet sometimes we can disagree and we can find ways to make it more acceptable for us. Humans are prone to violence. Further violence is often required in order to stop violence or stave off worse violence. As the rabbis taught, the rigor of law is essential to the practice of mercy. Pinchas may well have prevented national disaster by taking the step he did. The Book of Numbers often describes violence because our world is violent. I do not believe that the Marseillaise or Bastille Day are incitement to violence. They serve more as a warning. France went through a period of sheer violence and suffering, and today it's a country where human rights and the rule of law prevail. The law, as our rabbi said in the Talmud, is the antidote to violence and lawlessness. And there's a delicate balance between opposing forces, and our role as Jews, as citizens, is to preserve this balance, to see life triumph, and to create a harmonious society. Ken Yeratso. Shabbat Shalom. Right, so So next Shabbat there is a bar mitzvah here. Zach Scheib is having his bar mitzvah, and it will be a good another good. I mean, we're very lucky this year. We have a string of nei mitzvah, each better than the other. They're all just amazing. Friday evening there's a Shabbat service online. Next Friday it will be online. And is there anything? I'm going to check my. Just going to check my emails to make sure that I don't miss anything of importance. Gosh. Ah. Oh. Okay, there's a Book Crushers on Saturday the 10th, next Saturday at 10 a.m., which we'll discuss. Nobody will tell you this but me by Bess Kalb. And just, you know, for the rest, just have a look at the newsletter, because there's always a lot of important things happening. Yeah, the summer events for KLS. There will be, Saturday the 24th, there's a Shabbat for new members and welcome back all members here at KLS in the garden. Hopefully the weather will help us to enjoy being together outside. Saturday the 14th of July. Is it the 14th of July or 21st of July? I think I need to check it. Bar mitzvah. I think it's the 21st of July, not the 14th. Anyway, it's fine. So there's also annual garden party on Sunday the 15th of July, hosted by Tina and Neil Higgins. And yeah, so have a look. for the AGMs on Sunday the 5th of September, followed by a picnic and games in the park. So it would be great if you could all come for the AGM to show your support to KLS. So we're going to finish now with, and then on page 213. And then all that has divided us will merge. And then compassion will be wedded to power. And then softness will come to a world that is harsh and unkind. And then both women and men will be strong. And then both women and men will be gentle. And then no person will be subject to another's will. And then all will be rich and free and varied. And then the greed of some will give way to the needs of many. And then all we share equally in the earth's abundance. And then all we care for the sick and the weak and the old. And then all will nourish the young. And then all will cherish life creatures. And then all will live in harmony with each other and the earth. And then everywhere will be called Eden once again. So before we say the Kaddish, I can see that Melville Grayson, the father of Shannon Lister. Remember Melville on the Shabbat. Do we have other names you'd like to remember?
My uncle whose stone setting is tomorrow.
Okay, so Hillary's uncle whose stone setting is tomorrow. Zichronam Livracha, may their memory be a blessing. Please stand and we'll say the Kaddish together. יתגדל ויתקדש שמי רבה, בעלמה דברה חירותי וימליך מלכותי, בחייכון וביומכון ובחיי דכל בית ישראל, בעגלה וזמן קרי ואמרו אמן. יהי שמי רבה מבורך לעלם ולעלמי עלמיה, יתבחר וישתבר ויתפאר ויתרומם ויתנשא ויתהדר ויתעלה ויתהלל, שמי תקודשה בריחו. לאלה מן כל ביחתה ושירתה, תוש בחתה ונחמתה, דאמירן בעלמה ואמרו אמן.
Amen. Ose shalom bimromav, uya se shalom, aleinu val kol Israel, val kol bnei Adam, veimru, amen. מי ששיכן את שמו בבית הזה, הוא ישכין ביניכם אהבה ואחווה ושלום ורעות. May the one whose presence dwells in this synagogue and in your homes, cause love and harmony, peace and friendship to dwell among us. Adonai oz le'amo yiten, Adonai yevarech et amo v'shalom. Eternal God, grant strength to people Israel. Eternal God, bless your people with peace. Amen. Shabbat shalom. Shabbat shalom. And I'll see you online for the Kiddush in a few minutes.